Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Vladimir, I am a web developer. Today I want to talk about how to get invited to an interview for a programmer position. Initially, I received only rejections, where they said they found another candidate who was more suitable and so on. I didn't understand why I was being rejected, so I started analyzing and working on my mistakes. This is my personal experience that I have accumulated over the years. I hope this video will be useful to you, so please subscribe and enjoy watching. I would also appreciate it if you support me with a cup of coffee. The link is in the description. Thank you. I want to say right away that this applies not only to experienced programmers, so please don't write in the comments that I have experience and it's easier for me. Finding a job as a programmer at any level is becoming more difficult. I think everyone has already guessed that the topic of today's video is a resume and how to create it. A resume is a starting point that should lead you to an interview. It is the first step that gives you the opportunity to pass the interview and, thanks to a successful interview, get a job as a programmer. If you are applying for a junior programmer or experienced programmer position and are only receiving rejections and you are not being invited to interviews, this is a signal that something is wrong with your resume. As I mentioned, I had this problem when I was sending out my resume and getting only rejections. I revised my resume a large number of times. I tried changing the headings, adding and removing photos, rearranging sections, and so on. I talked to coaches and recruiters who helped with resume writing, and each had a different opinion. Let's look at how I created my resume that works in my case. For creating my resume, I use Canva. I like this program, it's very convenient. I will leave the link in the description below the video. Creating a resume. First, at the very top, add your first and last name. Next is the position you're applying for. For example, front-end developer. This is to ensure the recruiter sees that the position you're applying for matches your resume. Then write a short bio. This gives an understanding of who you are and what you do. This will be convenient for the recruiter to get to know you remotely. The next step is their photo. Their photo should also be friendly. Moving on to the work experience section. Here, you need to write from what year you worked. If you are a junior programmer and haven't worked yet, write from when to when you worked on a project. Then indicate your position, the company you worked for, and the company name with an active link to it. In any case, they can look up where you worked by the name. Next, describe your experience, what you did, what task you solved, and so on. At the end of the resume, there is the education section. Indicate where you studied, university, courses, and so on. On the right, you need to indicate your contact information, the technologies you know, and the languages you speak. The resume should be saved in PDF format and should not be large in size. You can also attach your diplomas and certificates as separate files to the resume. You can find the link to the resume in the description. Leave your comments. I hope this video was useful and see you in the next video. Bye!